Good morning, girls and boys. Thanks for tuning in and being a part of Christ Connections this Sunday. I know that we can't meet in person, but I'm so glad you're able to join me in my apartment. I'm Mrs. Castle. And so guess what, boys and girls? Jesus loves you. So I have a question for you. Has there ever been a time where you've been really afraid, where maybe your heart has been racing back and forth, where you've been terrified? I know I've had one of those moments. So back when I was about 6 years old, my parents and I, we were in the truck driving to see my aunt and uncle. And we had the windows down and air was coming in. It was summertime, it was great. And then all of a sudden my dad flicks his ear because he feels something, just a little something go across his ear. And then my mom kind of makes a weird expression, and then I feel something against my face, like, whoosh, and it goes across. Well, I'm really confused, and so I look over slowly, and there, sitting right next to me on the top of the seat, staring directly in my eyes, crouched up with his little feet pointing at me, is a praying mantis. And I was terrified. We're not just talking, Mom, Dad, there's a praying mantis. I was screaming. I didn't know what to do. I kept screaming. My parents were asking what was going on, but I was terrified and I was so afraid. And so I know some of you might be thinking, Miss Castle, Mrs. Castle, it was a praying mantis. Come on now. But that was a real fear to me and I was really afraid. So right now I have a question for you to answer at home. What are you afraid of? So tell those around you, maybe it's a brother, a sister, your parents, a babysitter, or if you're watching this by yourself, just shout it out as loud as you can. And so if you need to pause the video, that's awesome. But if you do have an adult in the room, make sure to ask them what they're afraid of first when they were your age and see what they have to say. And so now it's time for our Bible story time. But before we jump into it, I have a question. Do you think you could help me out in figuring out which Bible story this is? I'll give you three clues, okay? So the first clue is that Jesus is in the story. The second clue is that there's a boat. And the third clue is that there's a storm. Do you think you know what it is? If you think you know, yell it out as loud as you can. What do you think it is? Awesome. So let's jump into that story. Alrighty, boys and girls. Now it's time for our Bible story for today. So if you have your Bible near, you can open up to Mark chapter 4, verses 35 through 41. That day, when evening came, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along. Just as he was in the boat, there were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up. He rebuked the wind and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down and it was completely calm. He said to the disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." Wow, can you imagine what the disciples were feeling? There were waves that were crashing around them as they were on the boat. They're rocking back and forth and waves are coming and a storm is brewing. And yet Jesus, he was just sleeping down here on a cushion. They had to wake him up in the middle of a storm. So when you think of a storm, what do you think of? What sounds do you think of? Maybe what colors? What comes to your mind? Yeah, so for me, I think of a lot of noise. I think of thunder and lightning and the booms and cracks. I also think of how they're unpredictable. We have our best guesses. We have our hypotheses of where they might go, of what they might do, but they can be really scary. I also think of bright flashes of light, of blues and purples and dark colors all coming together to form this storm. And yet, you know what, boys and girls? Jesus, he has power over these storms. The disciples during this time were reminded to turn to Jesus to calm the storm. And just as Jesus has the power to calm the storms, he has the power to ease our fears and give us peace. And so, what does the Bible have to say about this? John 16:33 says, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world." And so, guess what? Those words that Jesus said are still to us today. Jesus is telling us that there will be some scary times when we're here on earth. We'll have trouble. We'll have fear. But you know what the answer is? We can turn to Jesus because he has overcome this world. He is so much bigger than this. He has conquered death. He's telling us we'll have difficult times while we're on earth. We'll have those fears, those worries. But guess what? Jesus has conquered death, and in him we can have peace. He will comfort us. He will come to us, and we can lay our burdens on him. He is there for us. And ultimately, he can give us peace in this world. So maybe you've heard the news. Maybe you've heard your parents talking, or have been wondering, why am I learning from home? Why am I not in school? There is a lot of people talking about this new virus, and it might be scary. There's a lot of unknown, and we might be worried about what it all means. But remember that Jesus is king, not this virus. We can take heart during this time because Jesus is beside us every step of the way. He is who we can turn to for peace during this time. And remember, just as Jesus was with the disciples during the storm, and he was able to have power over the storm, Jesus is with you, and Jesus is with me, and has the power over our fears. In him, we can find peace. And so now I want to take a moment, and can you join me and pray with me? So, dear Jesus, thank you for being with us all the time. When things are scary or when we have fear, remind us of your power. Comfort us, protect us, and help us remember that you are our peace. In your name, amen. Well, that's what our Bible story and lesson was about today. So now I have a fun little craft. And so if you all want to join me. Alrighty. So thanks for joining me for this craft. So what you're going to need, again, is a clear container, but make sure that it does have a lid that is secure and won't leak. We're going to need some water, about 3/4 of a cup, some oil, about a cup, some blue food coloring, and also, if you want, and if you have your parents' permission, some glitter as well. So first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our clear container, take the lid off, and also a reused water bottle, anything like that will work, just so it's clear and you can see through. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna add our water in. So it's a little under half. So there we go. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that nice blue food coloring and I'm gonna add in, let's see, one drop. And let's add in one more drop. Alrighty, there we go. And then I'm gonna take a spoon And I'm gonna mix it all together so we have a nice blue color. All right. And then now what I'm gonna do is I have about a cup of oil, a little more, a little less. The main thing is that we want a little more oil than we want water. So I'm gonna take my cup of oil and pour it in with my water. There we go. Oh, look at that. It's looking kind of cool. And now, because I like glitter, as well as it helps visualize a little better, we're gonna add just a little bit of glitter into our cup. And then finally, what we'll do is we will take our lid and we will cap it off. Make sure it's super tight. You don't want this leaking anywhere. And so when we turn it on our side and we start rocking back and forth and back and forth, can you see those waves that are coming? That remind us that even when the disciples were in the midst of this storm and there were waves going back and forth, that they were able to turn to Jesus to calm the storm. And we're able to turn to Jesus when we have fear, because he has power over those fears and he has the power to give us peace. And so if you want, you can cut out a little piece of paper to look like a boat. You can add it in there, you know, covered in tape or something, so you can watch the boat on the water. You can add a little Bible verse on the side. So that way, when you're worried or when you're anxious, you can remember that Jesus has the power over our fears and he has the power to give us peace. So thanks for joining me this morning, boys and girls. I hope you had a great time and I can't wait to see you next time.